new to CANoe and struggling with programming logic into network nodes? Follow our example and we will bring you on track. In this CANoe beginner tutorial series, we already created a configuration, added a database, and sent some signals on the bus. In the description, you find a playlist with the previous three videos. Next is to program some logic so that the bus communication has an effect to the nodes. We use a so-called application model that is attached to the node of the bed. These support CAPL, the communication access programming language developed by Vector. Alternatively, we could choose to use global application models that can be written in CAPL, C# or Python. There are many other alternatives to add application logic, such as MATLAB Simulink models, LabVIEW, or FMI-FMU, to name just a few. Here, we want to use CAPL. By right-clicking on a node, we can choose to add a CAPL file. We choose an appropriate name and save the file in a new folder, CAPL. CANoe opens the file in the CAPL editor, and we can see the template that was created for us. Within the predefined code blocks, we can import other CAPL files, and we can define variables that are available in this file. CAPL is an event-based language, and we can react to updates of signals with onSignalUpdate with the respective signal. Here, we want to react to updates of the signal head adjustment that is set by the remote. If the value is 1, the head is supposed to move up. In this case, we want to call a function moveHeadUp that we need to define in this file. Similarly, we want to call a function moveHeadDown when the value of the signal is -1. The signal is set to 1 and -1 by pressing the respective buttons on the remote. And it is set to 0 if neither of the two buttons is pressed. We can now implement the functions moveHeadUp and moveHeadDown. In moveHeadUp, we want to increase the head position and send this value on the canvas. The receiver could be the step motor that moves the headrest, or the remote that displays the actual position. In this example, we only want to set the value, independent of who the receiver is. Later, we will use the value in a panel to display the position of the headrest. The head position is stored in a single byte. It therefore has a maximum value of 255. It moves in steps of 5. If the head position is below 250, we must therefore increase the value by 5. Otherwise, we set the value to 255. Instead of using these magic numbers in this function, we could choose to define them as global variables within this CAPL file, add them as system variables in CANoe, or use them as individual CAN signals. The latter could be done if the speed is adjustable via the remote. Now, we do the same thing for the lamp. As soon as we receive the signal from the remote, we want to switch the illumination state of the lamp. In this example, pressing the button sets the value of light switch to 1 and releasing the button resets the signal to 0. The logic when to switch the light is therefore located in the control unit of the bed. We expand our CAPL file by adding the code that changes the illumination state every time a 1 is received in the respective signal of the canvas. In a real hospital bed, this could be a second canvas between the control unit of the bed and the light, or a different type of communication. We could also imagine that the signal is sent back to the remote that displays the illumination state of the light switch, or is transmitting the state to a device that logs the operating time of the light. If you continue watching this video series, you will see this last mentioned use case in action. In the next video, we'll add pictographic panels to interactively set the signals on the canvas and to display received values. If you want to follow along this tutorial series, subscribe to our Vector Tech Tutorial channel for more videos and check out the playlist from the description. In the next episode of our series, we'll make the bed visually react on a click to the remote. Thank you for watching.